Now, if you've always wanted to enjoy a cruise on a luxury liner but couldn't quite afford a trip abroad, your wishes could soon come true. The government has opened Indian waters to foreign cruise liners.
Cruise on a luxury liner will soon be pretty affordable. After years of delay, the government has finally adopted a national cruise policy to encourage the entry of foreign cruise ships to Indian waters.
No, the policy is always a beginning. It is a roadmap. It is an action plan. And the action plan may be perfect, may not be perfect, but at least something is better than nothing.
Cruise shipping is one of the most dynamic and fastest growing components of the leisure industry worldwide. With a turnover of $14 billion globally and a passenger base of over 10 million, the industry is witnessing an average growth of 12% annually. And the industry in fact is expected to double by 2010. India's share has however been a meager 2%, but the country's 7,500-kilometer coastline and several big ports make it a potential player.
Even not 3 or 4% would come by cruises. But if we have good cruise terminals and all, then at least we can increase this to at least 10% or 15%.
The policy proposes a number of measures including big tax concessions for both domestic as well as international cruise operators. It also calls for reduction in fuel costs, creation of well-equipped passenger terminals at ports and streamlining of the immigration facilities at these gateways. Some big ports have already been identified for infrastructural development to this effect. These include Kochi, Goa and Mumbai on the west coast and Chennai and Vizag on the east coast. In fact, in Kochi, Goa and Mumbai, the work is in its final stages.
The government might have announced a national cruise policy, but in the absence of infrastructure and proper port facilities, it might take several months before a cruise lover can actually explore India through the sea route. In New Delhi, Amit Mukherjee, NewsX.